back for more.
Is this a game tour? Again?
A tactical retreat. Wise.
I think I know who this huntress is, brother. The Aesir called her the Untamed Fury.
Why'd they call her that?
Vanir refugees, families, hid in this jungle to escape the Aesir. Ain't here yar, sir, but it was the Untamed Fury who found them, picking them off night after night until they were all dead.
They chose the wrong jungle, and her retreat is strategic.
By gods, what was that?
Tremors. From the earth. Or something else.
I never heard of tremors in Vanaheim.
Something is causing this.
Help them!
You know how this goes, brother!
Stay their camp to worry about.
Good thing you learned the runes, brother.
Tremors. They come from beyond that gate.
Let's find a way around.
The autumnal stag.
Hey, how about you follow me back home? Fall, get it? Yeah? No? No.
Well, at least it's attacking someone besides us.
We're not going anywhere with that dragon around. Watch out! You gotta break the pillar!
That felt closer. We are near the source.
I know you see me.
I am listening.
5 hours, due north, 2 hours, east. They said I would find this valley, a new home, after the Aesir destroyed mine.
So, what happened?
Come on, remember, I know that I wanted a new life.
Do you remember seeing anything that could help us find the other half of your hourglass?
There were 3 waterfalls. I remember wishing I could live near them.
Another spirit displaced by the Aesir.
Odin must have been really mad when Freya left him to do all this.
Odin was never going to stop. That's why he sent Thor here.
And what of Fae? Did she challenge Thor? Challenge Odin?
Who knows? But the truth is waiting for us, brother. There must be a way across. Have we looked everywhere?
Oh,
Another crystal for the pond. Aye, watch my head on these walls, brother.
Am I not always careful with you?
Oh yeah, always the lightest touch.
If something destroyed this tunnel on its way through, it must be big.
No matter the size, every creature has a weakness.
Huh. Quiet all of a sudden.
Get ready!
Of course, it's a bloody drink!
Expect the unexpected, right?
I just hope this means an end to all this shaking. Maybe by the time we're done in this valley, it won't be such a bad place to settle down. There can't be many more dragons left now.
Then what are we waiting for?
Another crystal for the pond. Well, shame that's the last of Cavassier's poems.
Why not write your own?
Hmm. Been a while since I dipped my quill into the inkpot of poetry, but maybe it's time to try again.
Chasing arrows!
Mimir, not sure how to ask this. There's stories Odin told me, like how he lost his eye, where the details are different from stories you've told me. And I trust you, of course, but they don't seem like things he'd have a reason to lie about either.
One thing to remember about liars, lad, they lie. They do it on principle, no issue too big or too small. They lie about anything they can get away with, and some things that they can't, just to demonstrate their power over reality. You must always bear that in mind.
Have you seen me? Where is it? My hourglass? Huh.
Oh, guess what? While Odin was giving me a tour, his ravens took us to Svartalfheim, and I saw Durlan again. He was actually trying to do his job. We pretended not to recognize each other. At least I think he was pretending. Point is, it looked like Odin didn't know anything about Durlan helping us find here. Hey, a flower. Are we just leaving the flower? Gravestone with the keyhole in. That's weird.
Looks like it fits a certain ominous hilt we found while searching for the Norns. Remember what I said, Kratos? Tread carefully.
I saw Durlan again, too. After we forced the spear, Odin appeared. He had Durlan with him, threatening him, as if he knew I would know him.
But if Odin knew all along, then while we were pretending not to know each other, he was pretending not to see through us. Man, he really is a good liar. Looks like we can land over there on that beach. Bet the dragon roosts up there. Up there! Back!
You will find a way up.
Behind you! Incoming!
This way. Push forward.
God!
Well, we've pushed forward. Now what?
On your right!
Your hourglass.
Thank you. Now I can leave for Volvanger.
A question first, brother. You wanted to make this valley your home. What stopped you?
I remember this valley. It was on the brink of devastation when I found it.
Was it a crater like you see now?
No. But the town was in shambles. Shattered glass. Buildings. There was no hope to be made here.
Did you see what caused the destruction?
A battle. Thor and this woman with red hair. They tore through the town. The rage between them was terrifying.
Thor was enraged. I'm not surprised.
No. The warrior. She was furious and fought like it. Thor was drunk, sloppy, but she was drunk on something else. Rage. It was out of control. I saw her fury with every swing of her axe. That battle destroyed this land.
These stories. I have known Fae's anger, but never to this extent.
We hide the parts we're ashamed of, brother.
Mom must have hated Thor for what he did to the Giants. Maybe that's why she did what she did.
She took part in the destruction of this valley. That would take a rage I thought her incapable of.
Perhaps you and Fae had more in common than you thought.
We both had secrets. But that kind of anger... I never saw Fae in that light.
Even the brightest among us carry darkness, brother.
dragons here.
Prepare yourself.
Incoming!
On the other one. Should have seen that coming.
Above you, father!
Dragon Slayer, you are. I've half a mind to write a poem about you.
Do not.
The animals. I can hear them. They said I was the last of the dragons. You did it.
We did it.
You sure did, huh? Mimir, I know this sounds weird, but can you tell me again what happens when someone dies?
Every living thing has a soul, and every soul has four parts. Form, mind, direction, and luck. Direction steers the souls of giants, dwarves, elves, and animals toward the Lake of Souls in Alfheim, where all the parts may be absorbed back into Alfheim's great light.
Hey, Mimir, do you ever notice Thor talk to his hammer?
Oh, still doing that, is he?
Yeah. Is he, like, charming the steel or casting a spell or something?
No, just a weird bloke.
wanted to tell you. I read something in Odin's library about what Gjallarhorn is supposed to do. If blown by a god, it sounds through all the realms and harmonizes the space between them. Blow it somewhere like Tyr's temple, and it would be like opening up all the realm travel towers at once.
It's quite a vulnerability. Wonder why he didn't just destroy it.
Some artifacts defy destruction.
Well, we should make Freya aware of this.
Hit the chime and drop off your lean worms. Why must you make me repeat myself?
You arrived! Just in time as well.
As you ask.
They look quite healthy. All of the little ones are now safely settled in their new home. You have my gratitude.
Thorough job. My respect.
You sought the dragon's offspring. Why?
Ah, to alleviate my heart-rending loneliness, of course.
Oh, that was awfully forthcoming of you.
I normally wouldn't be so candid, but it appears that Anxious Squirrel has learned a thing or two from you about, what was it, not caring about how others perceive you? So I will permit you this one glimpse of my weakness.
To require others is not a weakness.
My goodness. I had not expected such emotional intelligence from one of your... girth.
I do not care.
Oh, well, this was a delightful conversation.
Ratatoskr, I'm curious. You said the tree had plans for you. What exactly has it got you doing?
What do I not do, my decapitated delight? I overlook and maintain the stability of the realms, ensure that everything is running smoothly, and... of course, I tend to the world tree. I listen to it, make sure its needs are met.
Do you talk to the tree?
The tree does not speak in any tongue, but its intentions are clearly felt. Yes, I do realize how, for lack of a better word, kooky that sounds, but it is true.
Is it saying anything right now?
It's saying stop asking stupid questions.
Bitterness, manners. But yes, it is saying something along those lines.
Speak.
The tree has become rather overgrown.
And
if it grows too wildly, the branches risk getting too heavy and falling, which is not ideal considering they hold all the realms.
I am no gardener.
What an absolute shock. No, I do not require any horticultural skills from you, but I would ask that you keep an eye open for the stags of the four seasons. They normally graze upon the tree and keep it tidy. Unfortunately, Bitter decided it would be funny to trick Arrogant into releasing them. If you happen to find the stags during your travels, I would greatly appreciate assistance in bringing them home. I would have one of my spectral squirrels do it, but they, well, keep eating the feed I give them. Consequence of it being the most delicious food in all the Nine Realms, I suppose.
We have seen these stags.
Great! Then all you need is some feed. Once you've found a stag, the feed should calm them down. Then one of my spectrals will guide them back here. And, don't eat the feed, please.
I will not.
Bitterness asked me if I was too chicken to release them. But I am, in fact, not chicken-like whatsoever. So as you can see, I had no choice.
Yes, of course. What else could you have done? While normally this would be a harmless prank, Fimbulwinter prevented the stags from returning. And now they have long since scattered to parts unknown.
It was worth it.
Anyhow, was there something else you wished to talk about?
I was hoping we'd visit the crater again.
There's work to be done. See, the warriors still haunt the crater. We could put them to rest.
Works for me.
Stag of Winter. It looks hungry.
Come on already! Just come back with me! I don't care how hungry you are! That's right! We got more food at home! Come on!
I have to say, quite a nice change of pace helping these stags get home. For a moment, I was worried we'd have to kill them.
Yes.
You had a plan to kill it if it had attacked, didn't you?
Yes.
It's a shame to have left that behind.
Sure, I'm open. Hot blades coming up. Wait, feels like there was something else.
Love.
What now?
The riddle. What gets bigger the more you take away? Love.
What kind of chub-buffling relationships you been in, Amir? That don't make any sense.
Agreed.
Offer. I won't be lectured on the nature of romance by the two of you duffers. Gets bigger the more you take away.
Thirsty for blood before, you will be now. And the kid?
What? My face is itchy. I think my beard's coming in.
Is it?
Yeah. Jawline. See? It's growing.
Is it?
That's not just dumb.
It's not dirt. Bet we can get into that revenant camp now. It's like they feel more at ease as they're dying. Kinda creepy.
Anything illuminating?
Mimir, you said souls come in four parts. Does that mean you can lose some of your soul, but not all of it?
Aye. Form, mind, direction, and luck. Lose any one of them, and the entire being suffers. Still, sometimes luck alone is enough. Just ask your father.
My success does not come from luck.
Ah, the refrain of the eternally lucky.
Legendary weapon. You have a favor, Father?
No. They are tools for specific tasks. A preference would be meaningless.
I like the axe.
I too like the axe.
That's the last of the Seder, I believe.
Good. Maybe they'll be at peace.
If there are more, we will be ready.
Learn anything?
Mimir, if I hadn't accidentally put Fenrir's soul into my knife, he would have gone to the Light of Alfheim when he died, right?
Aye. Were he a god or a human who died in battle, a Valkyrie would have taken him to Valhalla or Folkvanger. Had he been a human or god who died outside of battle, he'd been cast down to Helheim. But Fenrir was a wolf, so his soul would have joined all the others in Alfheim.
Like mothers?
Yes. Like your mothers.
Father, what's the biggest thing you've ever fought?
I do not know.
You can't remember?
Why do you ask?
I don't know. So we can compare?
It is not a competition.
I mean, not yet.
Unless my eyes deceive me, that seems to be the Stag of Summer.
Is it hot or is it just my sizzling personality? Nah, it's you, Stag. Can we go already? Halfway there, by Septimus.
I do not like you.
I get that a lot.
Two down, halfway there.
just one stag left. Thanks for saving the realms and all that. I'd have gotten to it myself and with more style. But thanks.
You're welcome, he means to say. Surprise, brother. You'd think a stag would run in terror at the sight of you. Not exactly a calming presence, are you?
I am always calm.
Ha! Good one.
Spring, time of rebirth, renewal.
Oh, I've missed the smell of those flowers. I'm sorry, kid. Just come back already. That's all of them. Congratulations. Saved the Nine Realms from death by overgrowth. And you sort of saved my ass, too. No, it was really Venice's fault.
That was not our aim.
I'll take what I can get.
A joke. Done. Might as well check in with Ratatoskr when we've got the time.
The water. It smells so fresh.
Brother, we should shove the boy in.
Huh?
You've developed a bit of a stench, it must be said.
I have not. I haven't. Right?
It is natural.
Father!
Brother, I've been meaning to ask. Your homeland. I'd heard the gods there wielded every flavor of power you could imagine. Lightning, fire, the whole lot.
As did I, for many years.
Oh. Any chance you could recall some of that magic?
No. I have tried.
Freya said magic is bound to the earth. And your homeland died. The powers probably went with it.
Ah. Well, probably for the best. Let the past stay in the past, and all that.
Hercules of Cantamiles, or whatever the fuck your name is.
The stags are returned, and all is right in the realms. Mostly.
Your stags are returned,
Better late than never.
Incredible! The Nine Realms are no longer in horticultural danger. I cannot thank you enough, but perhaps this will suffice. Arrogant believes he has evaded punishment just because you fixed his blunder. He is sorely mistaken, of course. He will be in a remarkable amount of trouble. Once I figure out how to punish someone whose narcissism renders him invulnerable to all forms of emotional warfare. Well, any questions before you travel on?
There is one thing I'd like to know.
Obviously, the time has come to talk about me.
It most certainly has not.
What? Why not? How dare you belittle my accomplishments?
I apologize for arrogance. His volume has only increased over the years.
And why shouldn't it? I single-handedly take care of the ding-dang world tree. Without your boy here, the realms would rot off the branches before you can say ingratitude.
He does have a point. Tending to the world tree all on your own, it's no small task.
Of course he's got a point, my dear Mimir. But singing your own praises, it's awfully gauche, isn't it?
Who the hell else is gonna sing them?
And your question was?
Oh, I've utterly forgotten.
Splendid. Until next time, then. I suppose I needn't take up more of your time.
Away with you already!